going to do in the message today is something that I've done in other places, but not this particular message. So this is a whole experiment. We're going to see whether this is going to work or not. I've got some helpers over here. Carolyn is going to be our props person, and Abby's going to help with the dance later on, but I'm going to need people to take various parts of this play. So if you're really shy, you could be Abinadab, because all you do is stand there. You don't have to do anything. But there's also going to be two characters, Ahio and Uzzah. Now, what we need as an actor for Uzzah is somebody who can pretend like they're dying really well. In one of those epic death scenes. That's what we need for Uzzah. Then we're going to need a King David. And I think that's about it. Let me read it. And then we're going to act it out. Okay, so here's how it goes. It's from 2 Samuel chapter 6. Actually, you can blame Jeff for this. Because between Chris and Jeff, they talked about, let's do something on worship. And do we wild abandon and worship? I said, boy, it's got to be 2 Samuel 6 with David dancing the ark in. Except it's a longer story. So here's the story. Here's Act 1. Abby, can we have the sign for Act 1? What's the title for Act 1? Beware God. That's good. Okay, here we go. David again brought together all the able young men of Israel, 30,000. So you get to be the 30,000. Okay. He and all his men went to Baalah in Judah to bring up from there the Ark of the Lord. Oh yeah, that's the other thing we did, don't we? We're going to need two of you to be angels, and we'll show you how to be angels in the Ark. We got costumes and everything in here. Okay. The Ark of the Lord, which is called by the name of the Lord Almighty, who is enthroned between the cherubim on the Ark. So there's two cherubim, two angels, and they face each other with their hands out like that, their wings out like that. And we've got some gold and a little halo for you, and your parents can take a picture of the halo and preserve it for later. They set the Ark of God on a new cart and brought it from the house of Abinadab, that's the guy who just stands still, which was on the hill. Uzzah and Ahio, the sons of Abinadab, were guiding the new cart with the Ark of God on it. And Ahio was walking in front, so that means Uzzah was in the back. David and all Israel were celebrating with all their might before the Lord with, you have the noisemakers there? Castanets, harps, lyres, tambourines, rattles, and cymbals. Wow, lots of noise. When they came to the threshing floor of Nacon, Uzzah reached out and took hold of the Ark of God because the oxen stumbled. The Lord's anger burned against Uzzah because of his irreverent act. Therefore, God struck him down and he died beside the Ark. Okay, so there's the scene. Now we have to act it out. So we need David. Who's going to be David for us? David, all right, over there. She'll dress you up as David. Just the crown this time, not the white. Good. There's David and Abinadab, somebody who just stands there. Right, how about one of you adults, if you want to just... Okay, thank you. All right, it's on the hill, so go up here on stage. All you got to do is stand there, right? And then... We need a hio. It means brother, but could be a sister, I suppose. Who could be a hio for us? You're walking in front of the ark.
Sam.
Anyone?
Yes.
Sam. How about Uzzah?
Great.
All right, we got an Uzzah here. Okay. There's a little costume for Uzzah. Great. Now we need the most crucial thing at this point is the two angels to be the cherubim. Okay, so can I have two volunteers to work together to be the cherubim? Over there? You want to come up? You can do it. Do you want to come up? Okay. All right, what I've got is some gold mesh wrapping, which is a little itchy. Hold your hands out, like, exactly. She's going to bend, then she's going to tie it on. The way the Ark of the Covenant was two cherubim like this. One like that, the other facing this way. Below them was a box, like a kid's toy box. And there were three things in the box. There was a little sample of manna, which is a symbol of the Lord's provision from heaven. And there was Aaron's rod, which Moses used in several places, and had a little sprig coming off it. And that was a symbol of God's authority. But there was also a copy of the Ten Commandments, symbol of God's ways. So you have God's provision, God's authority, and God's ways symbolized with the two angels standing like this and God in between them. Okay, how's it going, Carolyn? Oh, look at this. We've gone to absolutely no expense for the... All right, okay. Good. Now, come over here, up on the stage. And then turn toward each other with your hands outstretched. Okay. Put your hands together like the wings are, like you have wings and you're touching your own wings. Like that. That's it. And then the box would have sat right there. Okay. David wants to move the ark from where it had been kept to Jerusalem. So he calls 30,000 young men. What does that sound like to you?
All of us.
If you saw 30,000 young men, you might think the Raptors just won. Or you might be thinking of an army. You know, it's a funny thing about Bible stories. They kind of lean on each other. You know when Joshua set an ambush for the Amalekites? He had 30,000 men. And when Saul freed Jabesh-Gilead, 30,000 Judeans. So David brings basically an army. And he's got the army out. Good for you. All right. And he's going to bring this stuff from Abinadab's house. We never did get Ahio. Who's the brother?
Sam.
Okay, thank you. You're on this side. You don't get much action, sorry. It's a small stage, so they have to tiptoe, and we'll go in that direction. So just tiptoe in place like you're moving forward. Okay, we need the noisemakers.
Somebody.
Somebody over there. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Go ahead. Okay, David and all Israel were celebrating before the Lord with castanets and harps and lyres and tambourines and rattles and cymbals. Go! Okay, here we go. Thank you. to the threshing floor of Nacon, Uzzah reached out and took hold of the Ark of God because the oxen stumbled. So maybe put your hand on your shoulder. Move back a bit. Back further. Got to get the angle right. Okay. Hand on your shoulder. And the Lord's anger burned against Uzzah. And God struck him down. This is your death secret. And he died there by the ark. Okay. Take a break. Angels, you put your rings down and great. Abinadab, your work is done. Ahio, I don't know why. Come on, God. Uzzah, you can get off stage too because you've done your bit. I have no doubt that this story happened as it's told, but there are marks in the story that show that it's also stylized. Whoever wrote this wrote it for a point, not just to talk about poor Uzzah who died, but why did Uzzah die? First, we notice 30,000 people, that's an army. So what is David doing in bringing the ark up? He's saying, God, lead my army into victory. I will have God on my side. Fascinating. Abinadab means willing. Uzzah means strong. Just because you're willing and you're strong, it's not enough. There's something more required. And then the noisemakers. What's fascinating, if you've read in Daniel 4, I think it's Daniel 4, where Nebuchadnezzar calls a party and everybody's bringing all the noise instruments out, it's pretty much the same. That instrument, that style of worship was very much like the pagans worshipped. So the whole way David is bringing God to Jerusalem was sending the wrong message. We are always in trouble, adults and children, when we try to have God bless what we're doing. God has a position beyond what we're doing. And he may have us on his side. We may be against God. We have to be very careful and thoughtful about that. So when Uzzah reached out, okay, the ark was on a new cart and being pulled by oxen. What's the message? Who's more powerful, God or oxen? It's the oxen moving the cart. It's a new cart, so our ingenuity, that's good too. You see, what's happening here is that the whole message is wrong. David gets really angry at God.
No! Yes!
And they move the ark to the house of Obed-Edom. Exactly. Who? Some guy somewhere. I don't know. Who wants to be Obed-Edom? You don't have to do anything. You want to be Obed-Edom too? Wow, you're just a kid. Okay, great. And you go over there, stand on this side, and so it arrives at the house of Obed-Edom, and now we are on phase two. This is Act 2. Act 2 is David danced. All right. Then David was angry because of the Lord's wrath had broken out against Uzzah. Why was he angry? Seriously, question. Why was he angry? Why do you think David was angry?
Someone died.
someone died in front of 30,000 of your own men. So the message to the 30,000 is, who's in charge here? It's not even David. God's in charge. David was afraid of the Lord that day. Oh yeah. And said, how can the Ark of God ever come to me? He was not willing to take the Ark of the Lord to be with him in the city of David. Instead, he took it to the house of Obed-Edom in Galilee. He was the Gittite. The Ark of the Lord remained in the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite for 3 months. And the Lord blessed him and his whole household. Okay, show us the blessing. Sweet. Now, King David was told, the Lord has blessed the house of Obed-Edom and everything he has because of the Ark of God. So, David went up to bring the Ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom to the city of David with rejoicing. Now, notice the difference. Very carefully, David changed the plan. There's no reference to 30,000. Remember, it's 3 months they all went back home. He's not interested in trying to impress his army. He knows that God is in charge here. Okay. So, there were those. Your task is done. We have the Ark here. Hands down. Better back up this way before David. Okay, and take 6 baby steps toward me. Both of you. Toward me. Okay, good. Took 6 baby steps. He sacrificed a bull and a fatted calf.
How do I do that?
Sacrifice the bull and the fatted calf. And a fatted calf. That doesn't look like a fat calf to me. That looks like a little lamb. Fatted calf would be... Yeah, exactly, fatted calf. All right. Wearing a linen ephod. This is a kind of robe that the priest would wear. So David now recognizes, I'm not going to war with God. I'm acting in the role of a priest. Right? David was dancing before the Lord with all his might. All right? And while he and Israel were bringing up the Ark of the Lord with shouts and sound of the trumpet. That's brilliant! Alright, you see the difference. David recognizes that to worship God requires sacrifice and obedience. It's one other thing that we missed here. The two gods. Good. I need 4 people. Yes, come on. You want to come on? Okay. 2 more. Yeah, come on. Anyone? Okay. On either side of the two angels, you're going to carry the ark. This way. Good. All right, good. There, good, then we got the other. All right. And they carried it on rods through things that were set in the loops that were set inside of the ark. Why would this make a difference? It's not ox anymore carrying the ark. It's people.
A cart might move a little bit faster, maybe that's why it stumbled. So fast may have had something to do with it. This is slower. But catch this. Remember in that first reading? The ark of God, which is called by the name of the Lord Almighty. Anytime the Bible repeats itself, we got it. Who is supposed to take the name of the Lord? You know the Ten Commandments, right? Do not take the name of the Lord in vain. You know what that means? It doesn't mean when you swear by accident. Do not carry. Do not take to yourself. Do not carry. Do not represent in the world the name of God in vain. The way God designed it is that people would carry God's provision, God's authority, and God's ways. This now matches the character of God with the trumpet, which is often associated with celebration, and David dancing. All right. We need to do a little dancing before Act 3, and Act 3 is really short, by the way. Do you know the song My Lighthouse?
Yeah.
Abby? So we're going to do this. This one's got some motions to it. Okay, try to do some motions. And kids, get up. And put the rods down. And Cherubim, you can dance to this as well and do the motions. Abby's going to show us. Here we go. In my wrestling, the motions. In my wrestling.
I don't know.
How would you do wrestling? All right. In my wrestling. And in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will see me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Troubled sea we got. Okay. Can we try that together? In
my wrestling, in my doubts, in my failures,
Act 3.
celebrate the Lord. Act 3.
Look at that, they just pop right back into place.
Well done. All right. I need one more actress. I need a girl who's really good at being angry. I need an angry girl. Is that you? All right. Stand right here. Very good. As the Ark of the Lord was entering the city of David, Michal, the daughter of Saul, that's wicked King Saul, watched from a window. So watching from a window, you gotta make your window. Yeah, there you go. Okay. And when she saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord, she despised him in her heart.
Oh, look at that face.
They brought the Lord, they brought the Ark of the Lord and set it in its place inside the tent that David had pitched for it. The temple hadn't been built yet. And once again, David offers burnt sacrifices and fellowship offerings before the Lord. After he had finished the burnt offerings and fellowship offerings, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord Almighty. Then he gave them loaves of bread bread. I got it at Zares. I think it was Chewbacca bread. Oh, Chewbacca. Not Chewbacca bread. Okay. And there's dates too. Notice, he gives them to all of the people. So who is the worship for? To honor God in a way that honors God, but actually when all the temple worship was done, who ate all that meat? The fat belonged to the Lord, something my doctor keeps telling me. But the meat went to the people and they partied afterward. That's the way God is honored and worshiped. When we have a party like we're going to do outside. So you can have some of that raisin cakes and raisin and bread, the Chewbacca bread, and the dates outside. All right. He gave a cake of dates, a cake of raisins to each person in the whole crowd of Israelites, both men and women. Notice, all of them. And the people went to their home. But when David returned home to bless his household, Michal, the daughter of Saul, it's too much smile there. I didn't give her a smile. Really frustrated. Point your finger at her. Other finger. The camera can't catch you that way. Yeah, that's right. That's right. And said, how the king has distinguished himself today, going around half naked in full view of the slave girls of his servants, as any vulgar fellow would do. This is crucial. Did you notice when Jeff called the kids forward and had them dance, how hesitant they were? Why would kids be hesitant to dance in front of a bunch of other people? Because you don't know what people are going to say. And the best way to tamp down worship is to have your thoughts and your minds on the people watching. Whereas you need to dance as if only God is watching. David said to Michal, it was before the Lord who chose me, and notice this dig, rather than your father or anyone from his house, when he appointed me ruler over God's people. I will celebrate before the Lord. I will become even more undignified than this. I will be humiliated in my own eyes by these slave girls you spoke of. I will be held in honor. And it says more about Meikle, but I'm not going to go there.
Okay.
Great. Let's give applause to our guests. Thank you very much. God is a particular nature of God. We have a tendency in this age to see God as my best friend. God is more than that. God has set a way in the world. God has provided things for us. God has the authority. Even something the glorious King David had to learn. Yes, anyone can approach God, but approach God in the right way, recognizing God's in charge, not me. God is not on my side. I can be on God's side, but that's me choosing God. And if that's the case, dance as if only God is watching. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen.